Hey everyone, welcome to round three. So yeah, we've won the roll and we're going to play first. And we have a slowish hand, but we're not going to mulligan it. It's got Sea God's Revenge, Nimbus Nad, and hopefully we can draw into some other creatures so we can bestow this onto our Vulpian and Goliath. Yes, that is the grand plan. So we'll just have to wait and see what our opponent is doing. He's keeping his hand, so we're off. We're going to play an island and then ship the turn. And ideally draw a Voyaging Satyr. That would be ideal. If I were to pick a card I wanted to draw, it would be Voyaging Satyr. Ooh. Maybe we will just trade with that guy. So we're going to ship the turn. Yeah, at this point I'd probably trade Nimbus Nad for Tormented Hero, because that's going to be a lot of damage that we're taking. Unless I draw a Charlatan and a Soldier of the Pantheon. Well, this guy's certainly got the dangerous curve, so we're going to go ahead and just cast this guy now. Whenever an opponent casts a multicolored spell, I don't recall having any multicolored spells, so I'm going to go ahead and block the Tormented Hero because I don't want him to bestow anything on it and make us lose more life. So we're just going to kindly step in front of there, take some damage, and let's see if he follows it up with a 3-drop. Hopefully not. Ah, I read the bones. And reading the bones means he is not putting more pressure onto the board, and that'll give us a bit of time to take a breather, you know, play our land, pass the turn, because we've drawn an uncastable 6 casting cost spell, as is the case, and he went bottom, so that's good for us. And another 5-drop, so we'll just go ahead and ship the turn. Next turn, probably play this guy, or if he plays a flyer, we can play this guy. Basically, it's all dependent on what he's going to do. So we're down to 14 now. And we're playing against Cavern Lampad. All right, so that's going to look a little scary. So what we're going to do now is, I think, play the Scrymera. Because that's going to let us attack. Then we can play the Vulpine Goliath and then Sea God's Revenge. We're taking at least 2, and if he's got something, then we're taking a little bit more. But if he has a bestow, then we can actually just block there. So it's not that bad. And it doesn't appear like he has anything, so we will stay at a healthy 12 for the moment. And he is adding to the board a Keepsake Gorgon. Well, that's a pretty good card, unfortunately. But we can attack, then play Vulpine Goliath, and then Sea God's Revenge and attack again. So I think we'll just do that. I'm a fan. So hit him down to 15, and then we can hit him for 9 after bouncing his creatures. So he's on 6 mana, so next turn he'll be able to monstrosity that, so we're gonna definitely wanna play this. Pretty sure he's not going to attack this turn, just because he wants to get a 2-for-1. He wants to kill our flyer and then be able to kill this guy also. So I believe that he was only going to attack with the Lampad. Unless he bestows something. Ooh, that's sort of nasty. Well, that makes things a little bit more awkward. So he can attack with everything, and we take 7, so if he has 3 creatures in hand, then we're dead. Additionally, by playing Sea God's Revenge, that's going to fuel his emissary, and he can just bestow the Lampad back on. So we're in a bit of a spot. And unfortunately, I don't think we are going to be able to get out of this unless we draw a creature that can block it. So that means that we have to block the Keepsake Gorgon this turn. Unfortunately, yeah. That's not really going to work out too well, because we just eliminate our clock also. So what are the things that we can draw? We can draw not too much, I think. We have to just hope that he doesn't have a 7th land, I guess, to monstrous this. And then next turn, if we draw the Opaline Unicorn, then we're fine, I guess. Unless he just has all creatures. Well, there's a second Lampad, a hopeful Eidolon. Yeah, it looks like Looks like we're just dead. So, boom. Okay, and that was that. So let's go ahead and sideboard in some more nulls, since he has all of those bestow guys. And we can take out probably an Omen Speaker or the Charlatan. I think Omen Speaker is probably going to be better just because it digs into Sea God's Revenge. But by that logic, we can just put an Aqueous form. And that's not the worst. Or we can take out a creature and put in the Omen Speaker. But this is probably fine like it is, so let's go ahead and...